The CarPlace Key Club is a student-run service learning organization that focuses on volunteering, fundraising, and raising awareness for various organizations and charities. Some of the events that we carry out are the Salvation Army bell ringing, our toy drive for NYU Winthrop Hospital, our co-run Battle of the Classes Battling for a Cause event, and the Jones Beach Breast Cancer Walk. The Student Teacher Fashion Show has been an annual event since 2009.
Well, the streets are empty, that's where we run. Everyday people do everyday things, but I can't be one of them. I know you hear me now, we are a different kind. We can do anything. We could be heroes. We could be heroes.
The Amputee Coalition is the nation's leading organization on limb loss. It is dedicated to enhancing the quality of life for amputees and their families, improving patient care, and preventing limb loss. The Coalition raises awareness about limb loss prevention and ensures that amputees have a voice in matters affecting their ability to live full, thriving lives.
I'm Gracie, I'm a senior.
And I'm Caleb, and I graduated in 2016. So when I was born, I was born a healthy baby boy, at least that's what my parents thought, and then as I started to grow, the doctors realized that my right leg was not growing at the same length as my left leg. So eventually it was diagnosed as a condition called PFFD, or proximal femoral focal deficiency, which basically means that my right leg was not going to grow to the same length as my left leg. And the options that my parents were given were very simple. It was either going to be, okay, we can either leave this, we can have limb lengthening surgery to try to save the leg, or we can amputate it. So they decided that something did have to be done about this, so ultimately they decided to amputate my right leg above the knee. So they performed the amputation when I was about 22 months old, and I don't think I got my first prosthetic until I was about 3 years old. And up until that point, I had never walked before. So they gave me my first prosthetic, and immediately I just started taking steps and running around. And you can see my parents in the background crying, because this was the first time they saw that their firstborn kid was, you know, walking and running and other stuff. I've been involved with the Amputee Coalition for a number of years. The first real dealing I had with them was when I was probably about 8 or 9 years old. The insurance company that we were using to cover the prosthetics that I was having made every year, just because of, you know, how I grow, they changed the way that they were covering it, or they weren't going to cover it fully, so it was kind of difficult for us to figure out how we were going to solve this problem. And my parents did some research, and we came across the Amputee Coalition, and my dad and I ended up getting flown down to Florida to have a prosthetic made for me, no charge.
I was born 4 years after him, so we kind of grew up together, and it was always just the two of us together. And so, you know, we'd be at the park or something, and you know, a little kid would point at him and say, oh, what happened to him? And I'd go up to them and rough them up and be like, Ed, stop talking about my brother. And, you know, kids would point and stare. I saw him grow up because I was always there. I saw him get bullied. I saw him go through, you know, the emotional part of it and growing up. But I also saw him conquer every single challenge that has come his way.
The purpose of this charity, the part that I really wanted to talk about was how when I was going into my freshman year, I was having a very hard time dealing with my prosthetic. It was really affecting me emotionally, and I was getting very down and about it. So finally my parents did some more research about it, and they went back to this organization and discovered that these people actually hold a camp each year for kids all across the country, no expenses, everything paid for through donations and charities such as this one. And they send all these kids who are missing limbs, who have all types of muscular diseases, to this one camp, and basically for 5 or 6 days now, however long it is, you're surrounded by other kids who are also amputees who have gone through the same struggles. And it's amazing because I went there thinking, I'm going to go there, I'm going to sit with a bunch of kids, with a bunch of counselors who are too afraid to let us do anything. And I have never been more wrong in my life. You know, I went down the zip line, I had kids in front of me rock climbing, you know. I saw a guy with no hands and no legs breakdancing. It was probably one of the awesomest things I've ever seen in my life. And it really changed me as a person because I went into the camp with no confidence. It helped make me into the person I am today.
With the camp, just the confidence that he was able to build going there every year, it was like he was a new person when he came back from the camp every time. He would get so excited, and we'd bring him to the airport and drop him off, and then when the week was over, we'd pick him up, and he was just glowing. Like, he was the happiest I had ever seen him. The Amputee Coalition gave him the confidence through the camp to push himself, to wrestle throughout high school, and then being able to say, okay, I want to be a firefighter, I want to be an EMT, I want to be successful. And that's what he did. I thought it would be like a really good thing if we could have the school kind of represent him and anyone else who's an amputee, and to show my appreciation for them, because they really did change our lives.
Love.